from bank to bank, with an eat up, oop up, waddle doodle and a kerplunk.
Battle Station's crew, I have good news. Due to the construction work in the schoolyard, Principal Gilroy has given us permission to give our winner-take-all parent-child not-for-profit carnival right here in this classroom.
Yay!
Now, make sure you and your folks wear old clothing, because there's going to be lots of contests featuring lots of slime.
Is it going to be disgusting?
Yes.
All right.
Now, events will include goopy golf, mud pie pitching, and my personal pick for the most yuck for your buck, pudding hockey.
Yeah!
Now, remember, we're trying to raise $50 to benefit the homeless, so sign up for as many events as you can. Hey, Devon, you're gonna kill in slime ball. You're the Duke of Slime Dunk.
My aunt can't take me, so I don't know if I'm gonna come.
Oh, that's too bad. Is your aunt okay?
Yeah, but she won't be around. See, her boyfriend runs these swap meets out of town, and he needs her to help run it.
So what do you do when they go away?
My aunt always makes sure I have someone to stay with.
Why don't you come to the carnival anyway? I'm sure we can find an adult to team you up with.
Forget it. It's no big thing.
You sure about that? Hey, Donald. You signing up for pudding hockey?
No, they won't let me play after last year.
What happened?
I ate the puck.
Wants to come to the carnival. You know, Phil and Devon became friends last week. Wonder how Phil would feel about bringing him. Virginia.
Oh.
Why don't you get some sleep?
Oh, no, I gotta keep cramming for my final exams.
Well, if you don't get some sleep, they'll be your final exams.
Maybe I'm five.
Yo!
Hey, did you find any good restaurants for Phil's surprise party?
I got the dope on several party palaces. This one right here is my personal favorite. It's got a personal private room in the back, a very popular menu, and a great flat rate.
Yeah, I just don't think Phil wants Ronald to wish him a happy McBirthday.
No time for taste.
Put those away. That might be Phil.
Phil, my main man, what up?
Crime, taxes, and my patience with you.
I sense a new edge on your usual disdain.
I do not want anyone to give me a birthday party.
You told me that. You told everyone that. I heard it last night on Arsenio.
Then how come I found this in the hall? Cafe Theodore, $20 a person for a birthday party.
That's not mine.
Perfect for Phil. My main man.
Busted.
Nobody listens to me.
Aw, Anthony, I am surprised at you.
Yeah, man, how could you do this knowing how Phil feels?
Nice try, people, but I'm not going down alone. They're in this up to their armpits.
I hate this. I say I don't want a party, you say, okay, no party. But what you really mean is now if we give him a party, he'll really be surprised, so let's give him a party.
That was a longer sentence than they gave Jim Baker.
No, hold it, hold it. Now, wait a second. I got a way we can work this out. Let's make a deal.
What kind of deal?
It's about Devon Robinson.
Nice kid. Good head, big mouth.
Now, we both know anyone you talk about that much you really like.
Get away from me.
Now, this Friday, we're giving a benefit to help the homeless in school.
Devon has no parents, and his aunt's gonna be out of town for the weekend.
You're asking me to play father to this kid?
Oh, Devon likes you.
Phil, you do this, and we won't give you a birthday party. We won't even admit you have a birthday. If anyone asks, we'll say you were hatched.
Why should I trust you?
Evelyn Dugan is gonna be there.
I'm gonna trust you this once, but you better not double-cross me.
Oh, do you do it?
Mm. I'm gonna give Devon a dose of discipline. This country'd be a better place if young people listened to what their elders had to say. Understand, baby girl? Virginia? Dead last overall. What were you doing back there?
I was trying to win a race tied to a giraffe.
Giraffes can run 40 miles an hour unless they're tied to a tree stump.
No, I shouldn't come here.
Amen.
You guys, good try.
We're having lots of fun.
But you just said
good going, honey.
This will prove that once and for all that women can do anything men can do. We are the power.
It's a carnival, sweetheart. Lighten up.
Anthony, Grandma and Sam are having problems getting untied. Anthony! Huh? The action you want is over there.
No, the action I want is over here.
Oh, that's Mrs. Dugan's student teacher.
That woman is the reason God created drooling.
Come on.
No, don't call over here. I don't want to talk to her. How's my hair?
Anthony, this is Hermione Davis.
Hi.
So what's it like being a student body? Teacher.
Hermione's studying audiology and speech pathology.
No, really? That's like my favorite thing.
Really?
Yeah, that's all I think about is speechology and path mythology.
Huh. Well, I better get back to the kids. Bye.
I sense a primitive animal thing happening.
Yeah, she's running for her cave.
Yeah. They're ready for the next event.
Right. Okay, introducing the event that made Freddy Krueger say, "Ooh, that's disgusting." Slime ball! Okay, let's form two lines right here.
Look, son, if we're ever gonna get out of last place, we're gonna have to start working together.
I will if you will.
I throw, you catch.
I throw, you catch.
I hit, you holler.
You throw, I catch.
Now, when you catch the balloon, pull your hands back like you're handing off to someone behind you.
Okay.
All right.
Okay, here we go. Now, the rules are simple but diabolical. You toss a slime-filled balloon to your partner. If they catch it without it bursting, then you move further apart and do it again. We continue until one team is left unslimed. Let's go. Wait, hold. Throwers ready?
Make sure you reach me, Grandma.
Throw. Oh, Sally, Grandma, you're out.
Good arm, Grandma.
It worked.
It's all about soft hands, son.
Okay. Throwers ready? Throw!
Got it!
Good hit, get out your taillights! Okay, we got two teams left. Will Lisa and her mom clinch the victory, or will Phil and Devon get their acting gear?
Good catch.
Good throw.
Now, this time when you feel the balloon, pull it in and spin with it. All right.
Okay.
Oh, no. We'll have to move further apart than that. Throwers ready? Throw! Yeah. And the winners, Phil Jackson and Devon Robinson. Yeah. So, how's it going?
Oh, no rest for the weary. Oh, good. You got all that slime out of your hair.
Yeah, and it was worth it just watching Phil work with Devon. He was terrific.
Why don't you tell him?
Tell Phil? That would be
Nice.
Right. If you complimented Daddy, you might upset the balance of nature. We'd have hailstorms, drought, locusts.
I'll give him a call. I'm gonna hate the locusts.
Hello.
Greetings, oh great master of the carnival. Stop making that face. Listen, I just called because I wanted to tell you I think it's wonderful the way you and Devon have become such good pals.
We have not become good pals.
Well, I think you like him, Phil.
Wrong.
Well, I know he likes you.
Wrong again. You're confusing affection with fear.
Okay, Green Beret, play that tough act if you want to, but I know every time you see that kid, you smile.
Hold on. Wrong again.
Okay, Miss Palmer, that's fine. Bye-bye. Well, as Aunt verified the note, it all checks out. She's in Poughkeepsie.
That's where Devon should be.
You got any more dental floss?
What happened to the roll I gave you?
I finished it.
Finished it? How many teeth do you have?
You know, I told you Devon would never phony up a note like this.
Well, if I ever stayed over someone's house, my mother delivered me in person and then spent all night watching me from the bushes.
Got any mouthwash?
There's a new bottle in the medicine chest, and leave some for me. What's with this kid and oral hygiene?
Well, you should see him with a gum stimulator.
Well, why don't you take old French Mouth downstairs with you and we'll call it a night?
I think Devon should stay here. He really looks up to you.
Well, he can look up to me much better from downstairs.
Sorry. This note gives Devon permission to stay with Mr. Phil Drexler. Now, if I were to take him, I could be arrested.
Two birds with one stone.
Come on, Phil. It'll be fun. You can stay up all night and make fun of me.
Well, he just better stay out of my things. What's that you got on, boy?
Oh, I found it hanging on the door. I figured, why wrinkle my pajamas?
Devon, I'd like to... Devon! Devon! I'm about to go to sleep, and when I do, I like quiet. Perfect, peaceful quiet.
Okay. Is it your birthday?
No.
Then what's this card?
Nothing.
It's got Monday's date on it.
It's a little joke I like to play on myself. Monday, I'll laugh.
How old you gonna be?
Older than you, bigger than you, and stronger than you.
You're funny.
Look, son, tonight is just a one-shot deal. Tomorrow, you go back to your aunt.
But she won't be back till Tuesday.
Your aunt goes away on business and leaves you alone for 4 days?
She knows I can take care of myself.
That woman's not acting like family. Family's about commitment. Why do you think I let my daughter and your teacher live downstairs for free? Well, I'm not sure either, but they are family. And you stick by family no matter what the cost, no matter what the pain.
You play drums?
Used to.
Really?
Let me educate your young mind. I used to play with a jazz quartet, called ourselves the Swing Set.
Never heard of them.
This was in 1955. You ever heard of 1955?
Sure, that was in the 50s.
Wonderful. We had a regular gig at a club on 52nd Street, Jesse's. Yeah, son, those were some of my best days. My wife used to come in and sing with us on Thursdays. She had this black dress with a red silk flower. She'd step into the spotlight and sing Honeysuckle Rose. God, she was terrible. But I didn't care. She'd smile at me and my heart would do 8 to the bar.
How come you don't play anymore?
I gave the drums away. Too noisy for an empty apartment. I still bang around on whatever's available.
Can you show me?
Let's see,
Here's a solo from a Duke Ellington tune.
That's cool. Let me do it.
Yeah, you don't start with Ellington. I'll show you a paradiddle. It's a simple beat. Goes like this.
Let me try. How's that?
Awful.
Sounded like a pair of diddles to me.
That's a pair of diddles. Well, you don't have to say it to play it. Here. Right, left, right, right, left, right, left, left, right, left, right, right, left, right, left, left, right.
Hey, Phil.
Hi, son.
Oh, hi, Daddy. Hi, Devon. Bye, Daddy. Bye, Devon.
Nice talking to you.
So where you guys been?
Devon and I have been on a day trip.
It was my first time in Brooklyn. You won't believe this. We went to the New York City Transit Museum. We saw these cool trains.
Including the old IRT low voltage type.
Now, that was my favorite.
Mine, too.
Did you know that every day, 500,000 people pass through Grand Central Station?
I didn't know that.
He didn't know that.
Well, some people just don't appreciate the finer things.
Mr. Jackson.
What'd you call me?
Sorry, Phil. Can I go upstairs after floss?
I bought you something.
Wow. Man, thanks, Phil.
That'll hold you till dinner.
See you later, Mr. Harper. Bye, Phil. See you upstairs, Phil.
Mm-hmm. Oh, Devon's a bright kid. He's got great potential.
Sure does. Be a waste if no one encourages him.
Yeah, well, that's what I try to do in class.
Yeah, but who does it outside of class? Nobody takes him anywhere or shows him anything?
Oh, you did today.
Yeah, Devon soaked it up like a sponge.
Good.
Said he'd like to do it again.
Great.
Often.
It's fantastic.
Yeah, anytime.
Terrific.
In fact, he said he'd like to live with me.
What?
Now, don't go getting all shook up. I told him he could stay. Now, go ahead.
What? How could you do that?
Devon needs a stable home.
He has a home. He has his aunt.
I don't like that woman. She's not a fit guardian.
Oh, great. Right. Let's just call a social worker and tell her we got this serious problem. We got this kid who's never been to Brooklyn and is receiving insufficient floss. We'll nail her on the grounds of dental cruelty.
All I know is Devon and I both think it's a good idea.
When did this happen?
I don't know. Started when this old lady on the train said you have a lovely grandson. And I didn't correct her. And neither did Devon. And you know something, Darryl? I haven't felt this young since Virginia was a little girl.
Phil, look, I know what you're feeling, but this is an impossible situation. Devon's not a neglected child. He's got a roof over his head, he's got food, he's got someone to make sure he's safe. Now, I know she's not the most perfect parent in the world, but Devon could be worse off.
He could be better off.
And he will be. Phil, you got a lot to give Devon, but he doesn't have to live with you to get it. Now, why don't you talk to Devon? Because the longer you wait, the harder it's gonna be on him.
I'll sleep on it.
Phil, you know, if Devon could have a new father, he couldn't have one better than you.
You think so?
I do.
Devon, you here? Devon?
Happy birthday, Phil.
Well, what do you know? A party.
Oh, it was all Devon's idea. I was gonna take Jenny to celebrate her final exams being over.
Everybody was real excited when I told them it was your birthday, Phil.
Yeah?
Especially Mrs. Dugan.
Happy birthday, Phil.
Thank you.
I'm so glad Devon thought to ask me to this party.
Me too. You're the only one here that doesn't live on Sesame Street.
This weekend, I can come over here and We can have a celebration of our own.
Fine. Get a note from your aunt and you're in.
Say cheese.
Surprise! Happy B-Day, Phil. I think you know my date for the evening, Hermione.
Were you surprised?
Like it was my own little Pearl Harbor.
I'm so glad we could share this occasion. Family, friends, togetherness. Let's go be alone.
Mr. Drexler, would you like some gummy bears?
No, thanks. I'm still working on one from last week.
Nice place you have here.
Thank you.
Yeah, I heard something about Devon moving in. Is that true?
Sam, why don't you go get the piñata? Phil, I'll take the kids in case there's anything you want to do.
Devon?
Having a good time, Phil?
Great time. You know grape soda's my favorite.
Mine too.
Well, why don't you grab some? Take a little walk down and have a little powwow on the patio.
Sure.
Hey, let's put the candles on Phil's cake. That should give you plenty of time.
First, I want to thank you for the party.
It's nothing.
Oh, no, it was something. And so are you. Listen, we got to talk.
You want to wait till they finish kissing?
Hey, Phil!
We were just celebrating your birthday.
I haven't unwrapped my gifts yet. You can't unwrap yours.
Well, you know, bye.
Devon, this weekend was a lot of fun for me.
Me too.
Good.
Good.
I want to tell you something. It's nice having you around.
I wish I could stay here.
I know.
But I can't.
Say what?
I can't live here.
When did this happen?
Well, I've been thinking, and I gotta stay with my aunt.
I see.
She's my family, and family is about commitment.
I've heard that.
Stick by family no matter what the cost, no matter what the pain. You understand?
Yes, yes, I do, son.
Good.
And if you ever need any extra help yourself, you talk to your teacher.
Okay.
Or you come to me. Anytime. Except after 10:30, because that's when I'm sleeping.
If you have a problem, you can come to me. Or if you don't have a problem.
Okay.
Yo, Devon! Slime ball! Catch!
Donna, what are you doing? Get away from that window! You guys okay?
Fine!
Well, the cake's ready. You want it up here, or should I have Donald drop it off?
No! 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 No!